Steve Lewis in the men's 400. He'll be in action when we return to Olympic Stadium in Barcelona. Coming up to the men's 400-meter semifinals, Butch Reynolds, the world record holder, Lee Evans set the Olympic record. And in this heat, the defending Olympic champion, Steve Lewis of South Central Los Angeles, who won the gold medal in Seoul as a 19-year-old.
His mother, Stella, enrolled him in a Pop Warner football league to keep him off those streets of South Central L.A. when he was 9, and only 10 years later, he was the Olympic champion.
Pan American champion Roberto Hernandez of Cuba is also in this semifinal.
He was inspired to run the 400 meters by Alberto Wantarena, the great 400-meter runner from Cuba, used to train with him.
And Ibrahim Ismail of Qatar, coached by Lee Evans, the Olympic record holder.
A lot of historic connections in this race.
Here are the lane assignments with Steve Lewis in lane 3.
Steve Lewis went from gold to gauze after 1988 with a hamstring injury, a virus, a pinched nerve. Saw 13 doctors over a 2-year period, but he's better now.
Top 4 to Wednesday's final. Steve Lewis in lane 3. Roberto Hernandez out quickly in 4. Now down the backstretch.
Ismail on the left of the screen is running very, very quickly. And inside of Lewis, Sunday Bada of Nigeria.
And Derek Redmond of Great Britain has pulled up with an injury. Redmond is out. Coming out of the top of the home stretch. And Steve Lewis trying to gain in lane 3. Ismail in lane 6 as they hit the straightaway. And here's Steve Lewis now powering to the front. Hernandez is second. Takano of Japan and Ismail. It'll be Lewis to win in 44.50.
Derek Redmond, the British record holder and an important member of that British 4x400-meter relay team, looks like more like a cramp, as he doesn't want anybody to help him. I think if it was a pulled hamstring, he would probably be getting some assistance. And look at this. He's going to try to finish his semifinal race. The British have a certain tradition of running which you have to respect.
A bizarre finish to this first semifinal in the men's 400 meters. Derek Redmond of Great Britain pulled up with an injury halfway down the back stretch. He's fighting off those trying to help him to finish the race in his lane. And now the pain too much. Swelling throughout Olympic Stadium as Redmond, with assistance this time, approaches the finish line he had wanted so desperately to reach. That is the Olympic spirit. Steve Lewis wins that semifinal. Lewis timed in 44.50 as Derek Redmond of Great Britain went down with a hamstring injury and was helped from the track by his dad, Jim. And here in this second semifinal heat is Danny Everett of the United States, the American Trials winner.
Everett's been suffering from a sore right Achilles tendon. Normally this would be an easy qualifying semifinal for him, but whether he can make it all the way around the track is open to issue.
Here are the lane assignments. Another American is in this semifinal, Quincy Watts in lane six, Everett on the outside, lane eight.
And Roger Black, second from the left of the screen, is out very quickly. Quincy Watts is going after him.
Black has already made up the stagger on Everett, and here's Quincy Watts like a jet down the back stretch.
Watts, a former 100-meter sprinter, sometimes gets over-enthusiastic in these 400s. He's obviously going to establish a fast time here.
Quincy Watts in front, Roger Black, Danny Everett in the outside lane, now struggling. He's got to make the top four to advance to the final, and he is dead last.
He's stopping, Tom. He's just going to jog it in.
But Quincy Watts has the race under control. It's Watts across the line, eased up in 43.71.
A new Olympic record, the second fastest time in history, and he eased up to that time.
He just jogged across the finish line in Olympic record time, and Danny Everett walks right now across the finish out of the 400.
Everett, the Olympic trials winner, he himself had been the second fastest in history before this semifinal. The U.S. has owned this event in the history of Olympic track and field. And they're the Olympic trials winner out of the final.
Many predicted a U.S. medal sweep, but Everett is now out, and that possibility by the boards. But Watts, man, he exploded on the backstretch.
I've never seen 100 meters down the backstretch like this, and look how relaxed he is. This is the guy who told me he's still learning how to run the event. I think he already has his PhD. Look on the right of the screen at Everett. That is not the Danny Everett we know. He starts to wince around this turn, and his right Achilles has been hurting him all year. On the left of the screen, Quincy Watts. This guy's not even straining. Completely under control. He's coached by John Smith, who's still the world record holder for 440 yards.
Look at the distance that Quincy Watts, the youngster from Southern California, has opened up on the field and jogged across the line in Olympic record time. Meanwhile, Everett could only watch.
Look at him on the left. There he goes. Just into the last straightaway, he winces, and it's all over. He might have had a chance to get up for fourth place. And you see him stepping lightly, protecting that Achilles. He doesn't want to rupture it, as happened to teammate Mark Witherspoon in the 100-meter semifinal.
Quincy Watts of the United States in new Olympic record time, 43.71, leading the qualifiers in this semifinal. And he is with Todd Christensen.
Thank you very much, Tom. We just witnessed the second fastest 400 meters in history. And Quincy, I got to tell you something, partner. The queue had a gear at about 220 meters. I don't think anybody's seen.
Oh, yeah, well, the queue is today wanted to come out and execute, running off the last curve. As the round's going, I'm trying to piece my race together. So I'm working on different phases. And today I had to execute the curve. And that's probably why you've seen the gear over there.
So wait a minute. You're telling me that we're talking about an experiment here in the semifinals of the Olympics, and that's what enabled you to get not only the second fastest time, but an Olympic record as well?
Oh, yeah. Well, when you're coming in, you're not really looking at how fast you can run. It's all about strategy and putting your race together as the meet progresses. And that's what I did today. If an Olympic record comes, hey, I'll take it.
Now, one of the concerns I know that you have is the fact that at the Olympic trials in New Orleans, you ran a personal best in the semifinals, 43.97. You went to the finals, only had third. Do you have something left for the finals now, Q?
Oh, yeah, well, I shut down toward the end. I just wanted to relax, and I felt pretty good. So there'd definitely be more left.
Well, I tell you what, Tom, if there's more left, we are in for a real, real treat on the finals.
I think so, Todd. In fact, the final has a new favorite. His name, Quincy Watts. Here are the finalists in the 400 meters to be contested Wednesday, including two Americans, Quincy Watts and Steve Lewis. And we'll be back to Barcelona for more track and field coverage coming up later on.
He tried to hop the last 200 meters. Redmond's father, Jim, came onto the track and helped his son over the final 100 meters. The crowd cheered Redmond's courage, but officially, the result reads, abandoned.
I mean, I missed the last Olympics, and I really thought I could pick up a medal in individual. I weren't going to bloody not finish the race, and I just had to get up and run.
Jimmy reacted like any father would, seeing their son go through that moment of Olympic tragedy. What was your plan?
Well, whatever happens, he had to finish, and I was there to help him finish. I intended to go over the line with him. We started his career together, and I think we should finish it together.
You didn't see it there, but a security official ran on the track and tried to toss Redmond's father off as he supported in the last 100 meters, and the father would have none of that. He waved the man away. He was going to be with his son in that poignant moment and bring him across the line, even though officially it doesn't count as having finished. He finished in his heart.